This video is about Asperger's syndrome and conformity. One of the challenges that a person with, like myself, has, and this is my own unique experience, is that people often say, or I've heard people say, oh, you need to find more interests, you need to read more, you need to be able to get out more, and so forth. Now, that's all well and good to say that, but what people don't understand is that there are some of us that have a different way of wiring and a different way of communication. And although this is seen as perhaps defending oneself and also making excuses to what other people think, it is the honest truth. And in all honesty, you know, I've had some people say, oh, you're too preoccupied with the election, or you're too preoccupied, you're too negative and you're too depressing and whatever. The way I see it, with my way of thinking, is that I'm a literal thinker. And I see things black and white. I say things as I see them. I don't beat around the bush or sugarcoat things that I see and I hear and so forth. Just very quickly with the election, Australians need to get used to the fact that elections are now longer campaigns, like that, I believe, which happened in New Zealand in 2008, where John Key had an eight-month election campaign against New Zealand's Labor Prime Minister Helen Clark, and John Key was to win that election. So that's one thing I wanted to add to this particular debate. But the biggest challenge is that people like myself have a different way of wiring, and often there's conformists that come along and they say, you must do this, you must do that, you know, you've got to give up Asperger's syndrome, you've got to not use keep saying you have a diagnosis. Well, changing the DSM-5 hasn't helped very much, has it? I mean, the people that have the diagnosis, now we don't have an identity, because the DSM-5 has taken out that identity which we could use to explain ourselves or explain the way that we think and feel. People just don't understand that, you know, people say that I'm selfish or whatever. Well, if I'm selfish, how come I've in the past I've helped out with Meals on Wheels, I've helped out in nursing homes visiting elderly patients and in people that in the nursing homes and talk to them? How come I've also, you know, help people along that have sickness and things like that? How can I be seen as selfish if I've been doing these things? I don't understand why people say these things and you know, that say that I'm preoccupied with myself and this sort of a thing. And it's very difficult having Asperger's syndrome because people don't see how exactly it affects you. And it's just that our brains, or my brain, is wired differently to other people. And I see things differently to other people. But when I have conformists that come to me and say, oh, you need to read more, you need to find more interest, you need to get out more, and you need to look for relationships. Well, hello, as I've said in previous videos and now, you just can't suddenly change and bang, it all comes together. There has to be an awareness and understanding, and there also needs to be a means of being able to perform such requirements anyhow, and it just doesn't come like that. The biggest difficulty I find is not having a lighter side, a social side. That's the thing that I find the most challenging, and I still can't really get help with it. I just have to deal with it as best I can. And for the future autistic children in Australia and around the world, what support is available to them. And it's just frustrating and annoying when people say, oh, well, I offend them. Well, do they realise also that I can be offended by something that they may do, because they don't simply understand, you know, what I'm thinking or feeling or functioning? You know, the main benefit is for a person on the autism spectrum is to have structure in their life. And that structure is something that we know is there. But without that structure, we can have a lot of difficulty. And there is a high rate of adult unemployment. And this is something that still is a problem. and not being addressed, and it's something that needs consideration and so forth. And look, I just do my YouTube video presentations as I say them. I don't judge myself on appearance. I don't worry about what other people think about me. I just say things as I see them. And I think that it's a difficult world when there isn't a lot of tolerance and understanding. There needs to be better community, better support, and support structures for persons. Like, one of the difficulties I also have is I have low self-esteem on some occasions. I just feel there's no opportunity either. I feel that, and I think this is across the board with younger people, that there's no sense of opportunity in this country. And, you know, like, you're just constantly worn down all the time. And it's not a very good feeling because, you know, you think, well, I'd like to be able to contribute more. And, you know, in your working and in your social life, you like to be able to say, I'd like to be able to offer more. But people just put up a barrier all the time and make it difficult. And regular people have boundaries around them, and it's just hard to make friends with people because they don't understand my way of thinking. And, you know, I find that particularly difficult and challenging as well. And, you know, I sort of find the relationship situation just so overwhelming that I just don't even know I feel it's just not even worthwhile pursuing because I just know I'm going to get hurt, stressed, and, well, not stressed, but hurt, and just disillusioned by it. So, you know, I think that Asperger's syndrome affects adults differently, but people need to sort of understand that, you know, some of us are locked in by routine and rigidity, and we have difficulties just getting through the world in terms of the social process. And when the conformists or tribalists come along and say, you should do this, you should do that, it just makes it harder and puts expectations onto us that really we cannot live up to because our wiring is not like that. And that's the thing that people need to understand, is that Asperger's syndrome is a different form of wiring. And although the DSM-5 has taken out the diagnosis, which hasn't helped, it is something that is unique to us, and that's the way we think and function. So I'd like to hear back from anybody else that has any other views. Thanks very much for watching this video.